Welcome to iLecture Online. Now that we know what a covariance is and how to calculate it, let's take a look at the covariance matrix. The covariance matrix is just a matrix where we put the variances and the covariances of data sets and between data sets. So let's read the definition. The covariance matrix is an n by n matrix where n is the number of data sets, so it's typically a square matrix. And it depends, the size of the matrix simply depends on the number of data sets you're considering. So here we have an example of a covariance matrix with two data sets, X and Y. So here they are defined, we've seen these two before, and we've calculated the average, the variance, and the covariance of these particular data sets. So here are the definitions of the variance and the definition of the covariance. Now the covariance matrix is simply where the elements represent either the variances or the covariances. The elements along the diagonal represent the variances. So here's the variance of X and there's the variance of Y. The off-diagonal elements are the covariances. That's where we calculate the covariance between data sets. Now, of course, since there's only two data sets, there can only be one covariance. Well, one because the covariance of X and Y is the same as the covariance of Y and X. These are simply equal to one another. In this case, they're both equal to 12. So when we plug those numbers in, here's the covariance matrix. Notice the diagonals are the variances, the variances of X, the variances of the data set Y, and then here is the covariance between the data set X and Y. And so that is how it's represented. Now, the reason why they put those in matrices is because sometimes we use matrix algorithms or algorithms that use matrices in order to calculate certain results. These are used in tracking algorithms when we try to track satellites or try to track missiles or planes or something like that. We use these kind of covariance matrices, and that's why we put them in a matrix, and that's why it's more useful in that format. So now we know how to calculate the variance, we know how to calculate the covariance, and now we know how to place those in a matrix. Now in the next video, we're actually going to go through the process of calculating some covariance matrices. We'll also show you what they look like for example, a 3x3 when there's three data sets. And we'll get a kind of a feel of what the numbers actually represent. So also, again, notice that the covariance is roughly the same size as the variances, and that has some significance. And so we'll see some examples that help us understand that as well. So stay tuned, and we'll show you more examples.